Named Obsessed, and my name is Leia at Team TBLC. It might sound alien, but everything indeed carries vibrational energy, and even self-consciousness is also a type of energy that vibrates at every brisk space. People's opinion, therefore, bear some value after all, and that's why law of vibration exists, and vibrational pattern can calculate anything. This novel is mostly a fiction inspired on true events that might have happened to somebody or also knew or didn't know. Names, characters, places, incidents are either a product of imagination, and any resemblance to actual people, living or dead events or locals are entirely coincidence or have been changed to protect privacy of any possible parties. Fair use. However, please consider this book as a sci-fi and any resemblance just coincidence, and the whole story honestly is unbelievably mind-blowing, so please read and listen us on e-books and podcasts by artist Tim TBLC. Portion of this novel contains a third-party content that constitute fair use under federal copyright laws of United States under Section 17, U.S.C. 107. Work are meant to be for educational and scholar nature, which is protected by fair use laws. Prologue. My name is Leia, a public relationship agency, also known as TrueStart, and private detective attorney. Matt Blues is a business partner who likes to investigate crimes pro bono. This time, TrueStart decided to investigate a strange case about spiritual leader who was found dead in his shower, and his ex-girlfriend is accused of homicide. This novel was inspired by true events, and there could be actually a lot more victims of this kind of unfair dating and love practices. So please read us and listen on other novels by artist Tim TBLC about Al Lambert, Devil Advocate, and Abby Petit, Nomadic Traveler, Amy Orki, MLM Influencer, Mark Dampalita, Businessman, and Jackie Holmes, Loving Mother. And we would like to bring our own opinion, speculation of what could possibly happen, and everything is changed just to protect privacy of the parties, just in case. Detective attorney Matt decided to investigate this matter after Elvis Zander, a charismatic public speaker, a spiritual leader for the whole church community, was found dead in his bathroom. The church community came to the agency asking for help to find the murderer and served justice for the sake of God. There are a lot of questions to solve in this novel. If Elvis' ex-girlfriend Cady Aliaps really killed him because of jealousy after he broke up with her, or whether Cody was a motive, had a motive and alibi. In true life events the novel inspired from, there could be more victims of this kind of dating, and that's why we're just bringing our opinion and speculation, so stay tuned. Chapter 1. A perfect match. Elvis Zander and Cody Aliab seems to be a perfect match, a couple. One of their friends even asked them, just totally kidding around, quote, if Cody was really good and nice, and Elvis said, already without kidding, that she was actually really that nice and kind. Elvis at the time was like, I never met anyone nicer than Cody. The friends and family thought the couple would get married soon. Chapter 2. Elvis Zander. Just outside somewhere in between Tennessee and Utah, Elvis Zander was a good-looking, a confident spiritual leader to a local community of Mormons. He had a good life for a young man, a long way from the life he used to have as a young boy. Growing up on the wrong side of the tracks, in Riverside, Nevada, Elvis was one of seven kids being raised by parents addicted to crystal meth. Along with his sister Kat and brother Sam, Elvis lived in a tent at the campground with their mother at the time. It was until their grandmother took the children to live with her, and who later introduced Elvis and his siblings to the Mormon church community. That is how, from this darkness, Elvis became like this, a bright star spiritual leader. A leader of Mormon community was so impressed with him, so he even offered him a job, like to run on a board and train people, prepare legal docs for a company that sells legal services, insurance to people who cannot afford lawyers. Elvis was such a powerful speaker that Many people would have tears on their faces listening how Elvis talks. However, it seemed that Elvis and Cody had a little in common, though. Chapter 3. Cody Aliaps. Cody was shy, a quiet person, completely opposite to Elvis' personality. She was raised in a quiet community in California, almost ideal to a big family, who maintained a very close relationship with each other, and each member of the family was happy. Nevertheless, Elvis and Cody found a strong connection in their drives to succeed really and do amazing things in their lives. That time Cody began to make Elvis worry somehow about her. Quote, "He gave me a Book of Mormon," Cody said, deciding to join Elvis in converting her religion into Mormon faith. However, the couple had a big obstacle to overcome. It was 400 miles of freeway separate them. Nevertheless, Elvis solved even that issue easily. He took his relationship with Cody on the road, saying, "There is a book I found, and there are hundreds of places to see before we die." But turns out that Elvis and Cody were doing a lot more than just sightseeing in a very creative way. The couple would call it later as a sex, because Elvis and Cody were devoted Mormons and they couldn't possibly acknowledge having sex outside of their marriage. It was taboo. Chapter 4, Sex Taboo, Celibacy. Quote, "I love telling all my friends that my brother is actually 30-year-old virgin, ha ha ha," Elvis' brother recalled talking to the press. Celibacy is one of the basic rules of Mormon Church. Elvis' friends and family know that he took celibacy very seriously, and his core beliefs was not having any kind of sexual relationship with anyone who is not married to him. People also knew and respected Elvis as close friend and fellow Mormon, and they all encouraged him to find a nice girl soon and settle down and finally have sexual relief. It was important for Elvis to be married to a Mormon girl and remain in the church absolutely. It was one of his plans for the life, to find a woman who is going to be a good match for him and good fit for the whole Mormon community. Quote, "When I just met Elvis' friend Cody, she introduced herself as a girlfriend though, and I was surprised at the time because I thought Elvis had interest in some other girls. Yeah, he definitely played the field," Elvis' friend remembered. Chapter 5, Other Women. "When, did you think he was cheating on you?" The press asked Cody about her relationship with Elvis. "I had a suspicion, I found it, and it was the matter that basically ended up our relationship," Cody responded, sobbing. Whether it was okay with her or not, it wasn't clear. But shortly after the breakup, Cody made a surprising decision of packing all her belongings and moving closer to Elvis, stating that, quote, "It was strongly encouraged by Elvis because he wanted us still to stay as friends and still hang out just without having sex." Chapter 6. Cody Friend Zoned. Quote, "When did you think that he was cheating on you?" The press asked Cody. "Friends with benefits, sort of, as far as anyone could tell." However, the friends didn't really know about the true nature of relationship, and it was still a secret for everybody what was going on behind couple's closed bedroom door. Quote, "Only he and I knew about our secret relationship, and we were having sex," Cody stated, becoming increasingly uncomfortable with the relationship, which was secret and seems to be going anywhere, nowhere. "So I know that I need to make some changes about my relationship with Elvis," Cody stated to the press. Chapter 7, A Favor Made. And just like that, early in 2008, Cody made a huge favor for Elvis by moving back to her hometown in California, leaving Elvis and the Mormons behind. And it really seemed okay to Elvis, and he thought finally moved on from that chapter of his life when things turned out that story of Elvis and Cody was far away from over. Quote, "Mr. Zander didn't just die. He fought for his life," the prosecutor said at Cody's murder trial. Chapter 8, A Murder Trial. It has been already about 2.5 weeks as Cody Aliaps has been sitting quietly in a courtroom, listening quietly from ear to ear the evidence against her. But Cody wasn't a stranger to patients. She has spent the last 4 years in a jail already, waiting for her trial to start. And now Cody was sitting there wondering how she ended up here at the first place. Quote, I have been sitting in my cell thinking a lot about my future and thinking what a waste of time it would be in case if I'm found guilty of killing my beloved Elvis. To be continued. Thank you.